We're in Ontario's wine country, Niagara on the Lake, on a beautiful fall day.
We're here with Volkswagen to drive the refreshed Tiguan. Let's get in and take it for a ride.
We're in the middle of wine country, Andrea. Nobody around. Let her rip.
Wow. Listen to that.
Sounds better. All right, Andrea, what's under the hood of this Tiguan?
A 2-liter four-cylinder engine with an 8-speed automatic transmission, 184 horsepower and 221 pound-feet of torque. It comes standard with four-motion all-wheel drive, and you can put regular fuel in this Tiguan.
They got rid of the front-wheel drive. There was less than 1% of people bought the base model, so goodbye front-wheel drive. But what else do you get with this? What are the key standard features?
The base trim comes with a 6.5-inch touchscreen, Volkswagen's digital cockpit with an 8-inch instrument cluster, Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, cloth seating surfaces, heated front seats, a leatherette heated steering wheel, LED headlights and LED taillights, 17-inch alloy wheels, blind spot monitoring and rear cross-traffic alert, and front assist with autonomous emergency braking.
Got all these different drive modes here. What do we need to put it in?
You gotta put it in S for subscribe. And if you can hit the notification bell, you'll be notified when all of our reviews drop and then you can watch them.
And we do this, the couple car review, twice a week. The first one drops on Wednesday.
We put out another review on Saturday.
So make sure you subscribe, hit the notification bell, but also follow along on Instagram. It's Motormouth underscore Andrea. For me, it's Motormouth underscore Auto, and the links are below. This video is brought to you by Car Cost Canada. Get the dealer's cost, list of rebates, plus discounted interest rates. Use the promo code MOTORMOUTH to become an expert member and get extra searches. The link is in the description below. So this is what you would call a classic mid-cycle refresh.
Yep.
New look on the outside, we're going to touch on that in a moment. But also, they did some tweaks to the engine, which are nice.
Yeah, big improvements here. I always found the Tiguan to be a little bit sluggish, not very refined, and I see big changes here, so I applaud Volkswagen for listening to consumers and for what they wanted.
It's actually coming up in Questions, Coffee, and Cars, so make sure you stay tuned for that. But I would say that, to me, is the biggest change in this vehicle.
For sure. The transmission and engine pairing, there's a great improvement. And it just feels smoother. It has a more comfortable drive. And it doesn't feel like it's working as hard.
So this is a mid-cycle refresh. They changed the front and rear and some wheel options. But the big news is R-Line is now available on two trims.
One below the top trim, you can get the R-Line Black Edition model. And that comes with black accents to the exterior. You get the R-Line badging. And I think it's kind of a nice change. Now, the Highline trim, which we're test driving, has chrome. I wonder if people would kind of like this top trim with the option of black accents as well.
That's one of the issues, is that there will be people that have the black one want the chrome, and people who have the chrome want the black. So it's going to be kind of interesting. The good news is you don't have to go to the very top trim in order to get the R-Line, which is quite interesting in Volkswagen, that about 50% of people that bought Tiguan went right to the full load.
They wanted this top trim. Right. And there's new wheel designs on this Tiguan. You can get 17, 18, and 19-inch wheels in this top trim, which gives it a really rugged look. We still have that boxy Tiguan design. Now, they do have standard LED headlights. I think that all brands should be coming out with standard LED headlights, so I'm happy to see that Volkswagen did that.
Now, on the inside, they're modest changes, but I think it all comes together quite well. A big one for Andrea is a standard digital instrument cluster.
You know I love that. This one comes standard with 8-inch, but it has an available 10¼-inch digital instrument cluster.
So one of the nice things is the base model in Canada is right around $33,000. They did a pretty good job with the packaging because they've added heated seats, which they had before, but also a heated steering wheel on that base model, and it comes standard with all-wheel drive now. That is a compelling package for a lot of people. So Andrea likes to dig in and find the best value trim. What do you think?
So one up from the base model is really great value. It's called the Comfortline trim. That's where you're going to get a wireless charger, power driver seats. You get the 10¼-inch digital driver display, the upgraded 8-inch touchscreen, and a power liftgate.
And leatherette seats.
Yes.
And Volkswagen's leatherette is really, really quite good.
And that's all for under $37,000 Canadian.
So you take that trim we just talked about, and then you can add the R-Line with the sort of black optics look. So that's a really compelling story. So Volkswagen really believes that the sub 40,000 market, which they've got covered with the Comfortline and then the Comfortline with that R-Line look, is really the meat of the market that they're hoping to grow. And I think they will, because that's all the kind of stuff that I would really need in this, right?
Yes, and also you can get a panoramic sunroof for $1,500. Zach, that would be a no-go. We'd have to battle it out in our house, because you know I like a panoramic sunroof.
And on any trim, from the base model to the Highline that we're driving right now, you can add the third row for $800 if you want.
And on that top Highline trim, that might be something that you want, because you get ventilated front seats and heated rear seats. And there's also CarNet connectivity, where you can actually start this Tiguan using your phone.
One thing I love about this is this comes with the Fender audio system. Volkswagen, please pick a supplier and please pick Fender. So they have different suppliers for different lines. So the Jetta gets the Beat system. Yeah. I don't like that one at all. I love the Fender system. It's clear, it's pure, it's a really good.
It is good.
For a mainline car brand, this Fender system is my favorite.
And on this interior, you have some soft materials and of course hard plastic.
Yeah.
But I really like this trim across the dash. Is kind of like a pinstripe faux wood. Mm-hmm. It looks good, and I think all the materials work well together in here, and I love this new steering wheel.
Now, Volkswagen's quite smart in the North American market, where we can tend to be a little bit chubbier, is they make all of their SUVs on the bigger side of their competitive set. So the new Taos is one of the biggest, the Atlas is the biggest, and this one is one of the biggest in this category, and you really benefit from that in the back seat. She's big, lots of room.
It's not best in class second row legroom. The Tucson has more, believe it or not. That Tucson is big.
It's got a long wheelbase. That's what they did with that one. But then you have the option for a third row, just for kids. Nobody's kidding anybody here, but it's in there for an optional $800. And then the cargo area is big, but it's not the biggest either.
It offers 73.5 cubic feet of space. The Mitsubishi Outlander has the most, followed by the Tucson, and offers about the same as the Rogue.
Big difference between the West and the East. There's hardly any Starbucks around here.
And we are addicted.
Yeah, let's get to your questions.
Time now for questions, coffee, and cars.
Your questions from Instagram.
Looks amazing. Love the color too. This new Tiguan has that look of high-end quality and solid build to it. Now, are those quad pipes real or still fake? They're real. Real fake.
They're genuine imitation. It's what they do.
It's what they do. And we see this with the Volkswagen Group. Audi is notorious for it. The SQ5 even comes with fake tailpipes, and you can buy a package to get real ones.
What are you going to do? Either you like it or you don't.
Your posts and videos are always so informative. Thank you. I like the interior. However, those haptic switches might be old school. I still prefer knobs and real buttons and switches.
Haptic switches. Okay, so there are some on the steering wheel.
Yeah.
But it works well. The only other one is the heat.
It's the heat. But the great thing about this Climatronic control unit is that you touch it quickly. It's just some quick tapping.
Yeah, you don't have to swipe it up or swipe it down. You just tap it. Up, tap it down. It's pretty straightforward.
And it's pretty easy to use. And guess what? There's still a volume knob in here, which we all love.
We're also here to drive the new Golf R and GTI. Does not have a volume knob. Zach's not happy.
No. Cross shop this one I bought 2.5 years ago, compared it to the Forester and CRV. Its interior, engine, and ride were two thumbs down. Hmm. Have these aspects of the Tiguan changed or no?
Biggest part of this, in my opinion, is the way it drives.
Yeah.
How much has changed?
The engine has been recalibrated. It are small tweaks, but what I find is that the engine and transmission pairing is so much better. It's way more refined.
Well, they really had to smooth out first and second gear. The car would stumble off the line. Now it drives so much better. I'm really happy with it. You know what's quite interesting though, Andrea? You think about it for just a second. What has Audi lifted from Volkswagen for the base Q3? This engine and transmission.
Yeah, yeah.
And Audi does a really good job calibrating their engines and transmissions. I wonder if there's a coincidence here.
Hmm. Could be. And you know, this Tiguan has best in class torque at 221 pound-feet.
Base torque. because there are other engines you can get.
Of course,
base torque. But this is fantastic. Yeah. I think they've done an incredible job with the driveline. Massive improvement.
Yeah, we're really impressed with it. I think that even the cabin is quieter than the previous model. It just feels smoother and more refined. Is the third row dealer installed? I've never seen one in it in Canada, but from what I gather, it's only good for kids or short trips. I'm surprised they don't go with a more powerful engine on the upper trims like the Santa Fe or Sorento. Maybe VW hopes buyers will move up to the Atlas Cross Sport for more power.
Well, what's interesting is we got a deep dive from the product planning team, and I asked the question, why not more power? Why not offer that? And they said when people were shopping for this car, this is their market research. They don't do it. They pay a company to do it.
Yeah.
Lack of power was not even one of the reasons why people didn't buy it. Styling was, actually. And so it seems to have adequate power for the buyers.
Yeah, they did not complain about that. And although I hear from you quite often about the Tiguan being sluggish and not enough power, people who buy them are not concerned about it.
Yeah. I just wanted to say that's one thing about the enthusiast crowd that really are into these videos versus buyers who just need a new car. There's a disparity there. And then the third row seat is about 25% of people buy it.
Yeah, and the third row is tiny. You are right. Volkswagen will say it is only used for small children and in a pinch. But if you really feel like you need that third row, even if it's once in a while, get it. Just keep it down. Use the extra cargo space.
They put the price up by $50. No big deal. It went from $750 to $800 bucks to add it. I would just order it with it just to have that extra set of seat belts to take a kid on occasion. That's what I would do.
Yeah, for sure.
And now it's time for our hot topic. What's this one, Andrea?
How is this compared to some of its competitors? And if I were looking to buy something in this category, what other vehicles should I look at as well as the Tiguan?
I can't get over how much better this drives than the old one.
I know, so
well
much done. Better.
Yes. All right, let's get into the competition. Andrea, there really is only one utility in this class that has a third row seat. What is it?
Yeah, the Outlander, this new 2022 Outlander. It's going to be coming out next year with a PHEV. Currently, the PHEV is just a five-seater. It's a good product, that Outlander. I was really happy with the fit and finish, as well as the Nissan Rogue, another great option.
The thing about those vehicles is they did a much better job with the interior. Ride and the handling is vastly improved. However, you still have a CVT at play. This has a 8-speed automatic transmission matched with a turbo, and those two vehicles have a 2.5-liter 4-cylinder. This is a turbo 4 2-liter, and it's now it's finally responsive. So I would say this goes more in the handling driving side. Those are just competent.
Yeah, and I also find the Outlander, when you're driving on the highway and you're trying to pass, you accelerate a bit harder. It becomes a little bit sluggish. It only has 184 pound-feet of torque, and I think that 221 pound-feet that we have in the Tiguan makes a big difference for this vehicle in this class.
Okay, we're on a secondary road here. We're doing 80 kilometers an hour. I'll kick it.
Yep.
It drops down a gear, no problem. There you go. We're already up to 115 kilometers. That's pretty quick. That's not bad.
Not bad at all. Now, of course, we've got the RAV4 and the CR-V, both great products, good for reliability. I think that the RAV4, we always say the bank of Toyota, you always get your money back, whatever you put in. But the interior is not as nice as this. And that tablet screen, I'm just so used to an integrated screen, which I love in this Tiguan.
The RAV4 is a great car. Like, we're not kidding anybody here. Yeah. It's going to start and run and do everything you want. In its favor, it too has an 8-speed automatic. Yeah. That is a bonus. But the interior really needs to be updated. This looks, I always call it Audi light. You've got a digital instrument cluster. You've got a big screen. You've got, a digital temperature system, Fender stereo, nice leather seats, heated and ventilated. Come on, Toyota. You cannot touch this.
No, I do want to mention that this comes with a 6.5-inch touchscreen. Come on, VW.
Only on the base model.
But please just do standard 8-inch.
Andrea,
this is 2021 now.
That's not the way the car business works. They want your money. And they need to get you to spend more. It's just an extra $50 a month, Andrea, and you can have that.
I just don't think it's necessary. 8-inch touchscreen for me, please, as a standard option. Now, the real standout in this category is the new Tucson. It is beautiful inside, and we drove the hybrid. It is just so refined
and big.
Smooth.
It's big.
And it went with an all-digital interior, and I think it's beautiful. I know some people miss knobs and buttons, but I think it's a real standout in this category.
So you want to know about this, the pricing, the horsepower, the warranty? Let's get into it with our vital stats.
Let's start with pricing. The base model starts at just under $33,000, and the Highline R-Line trim is just under $43,000. J.D. Power gives the 2021 Tiguan an overall score of 76 out of 100. And CarEdge states that the Tiguan will retain 51% of its value after 5 years. The Tiguan offers 7.6 inches of ground clearance, which is less than the Rogue and the RAV4 at 8.4 inches, and the Mitsubishi Outlander gets 8.3 inches of ground clearance.
Here's the fuel economy. 10.6 liters per 100 kilometers in the city, 8 on the highway. That's 22 miles per gallon city, 29 miles per gallon highway. The Tiguan can tow 1,500 pounds. Volkswagen offers a 4-year 80,000 kilometer or 50,000 mile warranty. Lightning round, two things we'd like to see improved.
I just love the refined drive. What a big improvement.
And the size of this and the option to have a third row is unique in this category.
What I'm disappointed with is I just wish there was height adjustment for the manual seat.
And I hope that they eventually have the R-Lines available on different trims.
Refined drive, roomy, and an accessible price point on that base model.
I can't believe how much better this Tiguan is over the previous model. The drivability is amazing. This video is brought to you by Car Cost Canada. Get the dealer's cost, list of rebates, plus discounted interest rates. Use the promo code MOTORMOUTH to become an expert member and get extra searches. The link is in the description below.